The Iowa Energy made the D-League semifinals despite losing several of their best players to the NBA. And tonight, the team sat one win away from the championship round of the D-League playoffs, taking on Tulsa in the deciding game of the D-League semifinal round. That's Mark Tyndale, drive, bucket, and the foul. And early on, the Energy were clawing themselves out of a hole. Tulsa had a lead. They came back. Jeff Trepanier goes off the glass for two. Then Curtis Stinson. Here, little nice handles, drives right through the lane, shakes off the contact, puts it in for two, but Curtis, the emotion got the best of him. More of that in just a minute. Pat Carroll, pump fake and the three. Energy in a hole at the break, and in the fourth quarter, things got very interesting. Andy Ireland live outside Wells Fargo Arena, where things went from bad to worse for Iowa. Andy?
Yeah, that's right, Andy. You said it best. The emotions just got the best of Curtis Stinson. Obviously, a game to go to the championship. It's going to be a physical game. There's going to be controversial calls. Curtis Stinson just lost it late in the fourth quarter. There was about 2 minutes left on the clock. Energy were down five. There was a controversial blocking foul, and tempers flared after that. Curtis Stinson gets tossed by the referee and then goes after him, tries to get in his face, arguing the call. He tries to get at the ref, is held back by teammates, by coaches. Stinson, the Iowa State former point guard, has been somewhat the face of this Energy team for a while now, and it's just a really ugly way to end his season and the season for the Energy. The whole scene took about 5 minutes to settle down. The crowd was into it. Nick Nurse himself was heated as well. But at the end of the day, Nick Nurse has to back his guy, but certainly disappointed with the way Curtis Stinson ended the season.
I was kind of trying to call a timeout to get the situation calmed down, because I knew, you know, it was still only five or seven with a couple minutes to go, and that was probably, in hindsight, the wrong thing to do, because it gave him a chance to kind of walk by one of the refs, and the ref got hot, and Kurt got hot, and you know, it's unfortunate.
So after that scene settled down, the Energy kept battling. They end up losing 127-122. Free throws at the end really sealed the deal. Now the refereeing is going to be what fans and maybe the players remember from this game, but the Energy were down 16 at halftime. So as bad as you want to say the refereeing was, the Energy arguably did it to themselves as well, Andy.
All right, Andy Ireland. Now, of course, the other question is Curtis Stinson. Was he around after the game? He got tossed there in the fourth quarter. Was he available?
He wasn't. Because that took so long and there was an injury at the end of the game, we were pretty close to news time. So I got Nick Nurse after the game, as you saw, but Curtis Stinson was in the locker room and didn't come out as far as I saw. Of course, we're going to try to get in touch with him and get his feelings on that later on.
Yeah, he was one of the players scheduled to sign autographs after the game. So interesting evening. Andy Ireland live at Wells Fargo Arena. Thank you very much.